our stakeholders and the public. I want to welcome you to this Facebook chat. First of all, we thank you so much for your feedback, and I want to tell you that we appreciate your feedback and your interest in the growing interest in the Bank of Uganda actions and decisions that we do take as a central bank. Yesterday, the governor read out the monetary policy statement, and he particularly stated that the Monetary Policy Committee, which takes our decisions on monetary policy affairs in this country, sat, and they decided to reduce the central bank rate to 9% from 10%. And many of you have come back to us on our Facebook page, where we are now, with a few concerns and feedback. And we are here to, particularly I'm here to answer to some of your issues and your concerns as you raise them. One person says, what does it mean to the public, me and you? What does it mean if the governor reduces the central bank rate? First of all, what is the central bank rate? This is as a signal. It's a signal to the market players about where the central bank or where the managers of the monetary policy want the interest rates to go. Other interest rates are, they move in tandem, in line with the CBR. So we signal and then others follow suit. So what does it mean for you and me who are out there doing our businesses, in the markets, doing quite a number of things? This is what it means. When the governor or when the Monetary Policy Committee sits and decides on the CBR, if it is reduced, it means the central bank wants to grow economic activities in the country. And this is what happened yesterday. The governor talked of closing the output gap. There is some space we feel the country is working, but there is some space we feel remains that people can work more and fill that space, the output gap. So what does it mean when the CBR is reduced? It means there is a lot of money now going to be available to the people, but that money cannot come to you when you're seated where you are. What it means is that, you know, the central bank works with the commercial banks quite more, financial institutions. What it means is that you now need to have economic activities that you're doing. Now, these economic activities you're doing, sometimes you could be constrained by capital, financing, you could be constrained by to increase your business activities. Now, you need to go to financial institutions and borrow this money at a now relatively lower interest rate. Now, there is another question based on that, where someone says the commercial banks don't follow suit when we reduce interest rates. Could be yes, but I've seen many adverts in the papers where after reading the CBR, the financial institutions start announcing their reduction in interest rates. Even starting tomorrow, I'm going to be seeing these ones, if you've been keen when we read our CBR. So if you are at home and you're doing any business, you won't feel the reduction in the CBR. But if you're doing business and you try to interact with the financial institutions quite often, you're going to realize and feel the reduction in this, because we are now having 26 banks after we license the extra two, Afriland, First Bank, and the Opportunity Bank. All these banks, the reason we license is to have a variety out of which to choose. So if this bank has failed to reduce, which I know most banks are going for suit, you move to another bank which has reduced. You should not have a choice of, from the variety, pick what you want to have and choose which bank will suit your demands. So this is what we encourage you to do. To benefit from this one, you now need to be, and also negotiate. Your negotiating abilities matter a lot. We can be in the same bank, but I have been given a different interest rate, and another person has been given a different interest. So how do you negotiate? Now, your role now as a citizen, as a stakeholder of Bank of Uganda, is you to know which direction we have moved the CBR. So that when you go to a commercial bank and you want a loan, you negotiate accordingly and say, we say, so the other time, it reduced. Give me at this rate. And they will give you because they want customers. 26 banks, where do you think are going to get their customers? They get from you. So they value a lot. You need also to follow suit and negotiate. So my point I want to have to you is if you benefit from this, learn how to negotiate, but also have something you're doing. You won't borrow money to go and do a wedding. You won't borrow money to go and the banks will give you money if you have an economic activity that is bringing returns out of which you'll be able to pay the loan. Someone has said the challenge is that banks don't usually follow suit. Like I've been saying again, the banks, if you have a bankable project, if you have a project which they are willing to fund, that is viable, that they feel you can easily pay back, they will sit you down and they will want to bring you on board. Many times is when you hear that the bank has reduced the interest rate or the CBR, you run the bank, you have no project, you have nothing, you're showing no project proposal, and you just go to the bank and say, give me a loan. The bank won't give you a loan. They will give you a loan for the economic activities you're doing because they want that loan to be paid back. So if you want, you have your business and you want to get more capital for the business, yeah, this is the time now you to go back and ask either for extra funding or top up at a reduced interest rate. Secondly, if you got your loan at, you know, we have two ways you can get your loan fixed or an interest rate which is flexible. If your interest rate if your loan was got at a flexible interest rate, now this is time for you. Go to the commercial bank and say, hey, now my loan has to go with the new rate. And they will definitely follow suit. So this is for, again, your empowerment. Don't allow just to go and say they have not reduced. I know banks will reduce because they want you, the customers. But if the loan was got at a fixed interest rate, you agree that it's fixed. So that means if it goes down, you won't benefit from it. It's the same way if we had increased, still you would be safer because they wouldn't increase yours. So there is that way when you're getting a loan, you need to determine, can I get at a fixed? Can I get at a flexible? These ones you need to, how to determine this, you need to consult, including consulting Bank of Uganda. We have a good engagement. How can I go for a fixed one? Can I go for a reducing? And even the commercial banks there, they have people who should be advising you, including lawyers, including. So ask them before you go into some other things. And this should be stated. The interest rate's nature should be stated in your key facts document. If it's flexible or if it is fixed. If it's flexible, it's time for you to benefit. If it's fixed, you remain at your planned rate. Now, one of our stakeholders indicated and was saying it doesn't impact on the borrowers from commercial banks because the rates don't change. Again, I have answered that one. The CBR has been reduced by the central bank and cannot coerce commercial banks. We can't coerce indeed. We can't force the commercial banks to reduce. But we talk to them. The governor keeps talking to the CEOs of these commercial banks, financial institutions. Why? He keeps saying, we want you to follow what we're doing. Follow suit. We reduce, you also reduce appropriately. But even if before the governor talks to them, they want customers. That's why no bank can remain at 40%, which we had previously when we were starting inflation targeting. Why? Because you lose customers. This is a free market. You cheat me, I go away to another bank. 26 banks, like I said. You cheat me, I go to another one. So I want us to be considerate. We don't rule out the fact that some banks maybe might be delay to reduce on the interest rates, but definitely they will follow suit because this is a market. We're all in one market. You don't, I go to another bank. Another one says, my $1 million question is unanswered still. Why the reduction in the commercial bank lending rates never reciprocates in the commercial banks that are flying at 20%? Yes, but the one thing we need to understand, fellow Ugandans, the banks, what do the banks do? The banks do a money business. They get a loan from wherever they get from, the sources they borrow from, And they create and they lend to others. So they trade in money. They trade in money in a way that they buy money at a lower interest rate and they sell it to you who you want to borrow at a high interest that can cover their costs. And what are their costs? They need to pay for rent, the buildings where they are. They need to pay some money to pay back the money to the guy they've borrowed from, which is also called interest rate. They also need to pay dividends for their shareholders, the owners of the banks. So there are costs that go in there. But also, I want us to agree that there are some people who borrow money and they're highly risky. That risk premium. So they assess the risks of different people. Like I said it from the word go, you might find in the same bank someone is taking money at 17%. And it maybe for you, they're giving you at 20%. Why? Depending on the risk assessment of your portfolio, your nature. For instance, if you don't have any business, or if your business is probably new in the sector, the banks may feel so risky to lend to you. You've just got your credit card, your card from assessing your loans, and then the other person has been borrowing and he has a good record of paying. Definitely you can't be at the same rate. The other has a good record, so it becomes very easier for the bank to renew his loan because he pays. Now for a new borrower, it will be quite hard to lend to you. Secondly, some businesses are riskier than others, although they may be having good returns. For example, someone who is in real estate, it could be having good returns, but it's highly risky. So for the first time, the bank might be very cagey and probably go slow to lending to you than someone who has some business that is quite probably obvious. So the banks assess these risks and then they determine how much interest rate to charge you based on those risks. If they were just lending to people like that, then it would be probably having a problem. Don't forget that the banks, the money the banks lend is money and keep their money there. So if they lend this money recklessly, there is a possibility or there is a chance that they may go into default, those guys that have borrowed money recklessly. And that means the banks have a mandate yet to pay back the loan they have got from the depositors. So they are very careful, and actually this being careful starts from the Bank of Uganda, because when we are regulating them, we are mindful of keeping depositors' money safe. So we don't want them to go carelessly lending and they probably end up in default. So the issue is there will always be that interest gap between how much they borrow at and how much they are lending it at, because that's where they benefit from. But we are not saying they should overcharge you. We are also saying you also need to be considerate when you're borrowing, because they will never lend to you at the same rate which they borrow from other people who lend to them before they can lend to you, because their money is money business. So again, it goes to what I've been telling you. You need to be able to negotiate. If you have a good project, you have a good security, why don't you go and negotiate and say, of course, you know that CBR is at 9. So if you factor in other risks there that the banks incur, you should be able to negotiate based on the fundamentals. The CBR is at 9%. And then we have the discount rate. So if the banks are borrowing from their sources at 14, definitely don't expect them to borrow at 14. So they will charge you at around 19 if you have a good project. So negotiate around that. And now that means you also need to be, for any business, you also need to be alive at the new things that are happening in the country. You need to be nosing to this one, the other one, as a good business person, so that you're not lied into, you're not cheated, and you'll be able to, once you have a lot of information about what's going on in the country, you'll have a very good bargaining power and the world will be easy for you. So I want to invite you that we shall continue engaging on this platform. Bring all the questions that you feel you may need the Bank of Uganda to address, and we shall be able to address. Chivirige, you've just said to those with no economic activities and yet they deceive the part of the growing people, how will you help them get money to carry out economic activity? To those who have no economic activities. It is not that the commercial banks or the financial institutions only lend to those who have businesses. No. Actually, many financial institutions that I know lend startup projects, but you should write your project well. Write your project proposal well and go and interest these people. Work in these institutions. They are your institutions. Decisions are yours. These banks open in Uganda because they want you. If you borrowers were not there, they would not be happening. So go to the institution, sit with the branch manager. This is my project. I want you to be funded. But you must be having collateral security. In case you don't pay, how can I recover my money? Once you have good collateral security and you have a good bankable project, the bank will not fail to give you money. So don't fear that you cannot start a project. I read somewhere where they said the guy who made Ford the cars, which most of us like, he was rejected many times before he was funded. So don't be brought down because you've got one bank and has refused to fund your startup project. Go to another bank. Like I said, there are 26 banks. One bank will lend to you, and this is a story you'll be telling people, that I went to 5 banks, they refused. But so our role as Bank of Uganda, like I said, is to provide a variety. That's why we're licensed extra 2 banks. So you move to us. And the advantage is that most of these banks are in Kampala. So you move this one, don't even need a car. Go this one, they refuse, go to another one. As long as you have a good project, these banks will fund you because they want customers. And secondly, the reason they exist is to trade into lending money. So why should they refuse to lend you money if you have a good project? The issue, usually the challenge is, because even me, I borrow from the commercial banks. The bank is not a lender. I borrow from there. Once you don't have a good project, it doesn't matter where you work. Even if you work in the central bank, they will deny you this loan. All you need is to write your project proposal well, have attention to your project, and then face and negotiate and convince them they will give you this loan. And trust me, you'll come and testify here on this platform that you'll come here to thank me for that. So with us, we want it to be a two-way, and we shall be glad to engage you. Without you, we are not there. So it's you and us that can make this economy work well. You borrow, the commercial banks exist, you exist, you make profits, you pay back your loan, you pay tax, some people get the jobs, you also get money, and we continue like that. And that's what we call the economy. Thank you so very much for listening and watching us.